make two and make two curves which intersect with their working plans. So, for example, in this case, let me show the curves which made the curve. This is the line I made. This is the line, as you see, it's highlighted light blue. First, I made this line here. Then, secondly, I made another line which will be intersecting with this one. Here you see those two lines, those two curves indeed, intersect in the 3D space and create this 3D curve here. So I define in the top view, I define the border, okay, and in the side view with another sketch I drew this profile, as you see. Then I used, here we go, show it to you, I used project curve, which is here, and I'll show you how it works here. As you see, in order to use this project curve, I selected this highlighted curve, and the second curve here with the side view, and when they intersect in the 3D space, they form this 3D curve. I hope you got the idea. If you have any questions about these details, please let me know. So, that's all for the 3D curve. After I make this 3D curve here, I use the planes I made previously and make these skits on these planes, and all the endpoints of these skits constrained the 3D curve here. Let's look at this one, for example, what I did with this. As you see, I can hide the plane here. As you see, I made a line, horizontal line, and this endpoint, is constrained with the curve here, this red line coming up to this end. And the purpose of this line is I want to make a tangent, because I'm going to use the mirror command after I make all these surfaces in this part, and we'll mirror all these surfaces to the other side. So in order to create a continuous surface at the top and all other parts of the mouse, we need to create tangency, or we need to perform tangency conditions. So that's why I put, as you see here, I create tangency constraint, and this point here I make pierce point with this curve. So pierce, you can use this pierce point command in order to match the endpoint of the line with the other curve you want it to be constrained with. Okay, hope you understand this. Okay, so I'm closing this line, and as you see, all the profiles are defined. Now we'll make our first surface. Here we go. Okay, now I'll close all these curves in order to make them not to confuse your mind in the future steps. Close all these curves. Okay, so let's check it out. As you see, it is it matches the border lines, borders of the image we got as the initial input. Even in the top view, it again performs a nice geometry here. So we created our geometry. I can show it in detail. Here we go. As you see, so I put in order to perform tangency conditions, I set normal to profile option with this line, because I need tangency the other side. We mirror this. We have to perform the at least minimum conditions of tangency in order to create a continuum on the surface. So, and you see that those are the profiles which are defined in direction 2 here, and as the direction 1 we have the 3D curve here and the initial curve I made for the top surface of the Mars. Okay, so after this surface we need to make a secondary surface which will be closing the front part. So initially I made, before showing the surface, I made these border lines which defines the borders of the upcoming surface here. Now it's better to close other supportive curves which I made previously in order to make things clear. Okay, so those are the curves which define the border of the surface which we are going to make now. You understand it? Because this line comes from the initial sketch which I draw following up the border of the image I got first. So I just copied it here. I didn't draw another new curve on this plane because it needs to be much better to keep up. But okay, so let's see the second surface. You got it here. So I can hide all these sketches again, and let's go to the third one. So this is one of the most important part. I mean, this surface was the most important one, and the second important part is the side surfaces of the mouse. Well, as you see, there's a concave surface along the profile alongside this view. You can see the concave surface inside on the geometry here, but you can make many other details defining other profiles, you know, between this edge of the surface and the at this top curve, you know. But I didn't do it. I tried to make it simple, but you can make many other